Are you looking to make your images literally pop off the page, but you'd like to do it in one click? Well, stay tuned. I'm going to show you how you can use shadow effects, also known as a drop shadow, to give your images that look you're looking for, to make them pop off the page and literally stand out in the crowd in a snap. You know why I'm so excited today is because today I get to create images for my website. Don't you love it? You get to create all these beautiful images for your website. It is super fun. But what is not so super fun is all of those technical steps you have to do over and over and over again with every single image so that you give them that pop off the page look you're wanting to make them stand out in the crowd. And let me tell you, standing out in the crowd in the wide expanse of the internet ocean is really tough to do. You have to make sure that every single one of your images literally pops off the page because every single one needs to capture your audience's attention. But the problem with that is that those repetitive steps that you've got to do to add dimension and shadow effect and weight to every single one of your images, they're time consuming, they're repetitive, they're not creative. And more importantly, that's the whole point. You want to be spending more time actually creating new and valuable content for your audience instead of spending more time on those repetitive tasks. Repetitive tasks? Creating new content? This is your sweet spot right here. Hello. Does this sound familiar? Oh, I wish I had an easy resource that would compress most of the repetitive technical tasks involved in creating shadow effects for my images into a simple add-in feature and support me so I could spend more of my time creating new content rather than spending so much of my time on repetitive tasks while providing me a high-quality, beautiful, and effective outcome that still looks like I customized every detail. Would you like to do that, but maybe with just one click? Well, stay tuned. I'm going to show you how you can add shadow effects, also known as a drop shadow, to give you that look you're wanting, that pop off the page look, so that your image will truly stand out in the crowd, simply, beautifully, effectively, still custom, but in one click. So that your image will stand out in the crowd, but in a snap. Oh, hi. So, are you ready to learn? Come on, I'll show you. And you'll be doing it in a snap. Okay, let's chat. Let's start with the basics. What are shadow effects? Shadow effects, also known as a drop shadow, are visual elements that are added to your design to do exactly what it says. It gives a shadow to the image. The shadow creates a dimensional effect, making the image appear to be raised above the background or objects behind it. Here you can see two examples of images, one image without any shadow effects, and the other image here with shadow effects. As you can see, adding the shadow effects here in the second image, this one has both a primary shadow here and a secondary shadow going around the outside edge here. This second image transforms this flat image into an image that really pops off the page beautifully and realistically. Ooh, I like it. So, what else are shadow effects good for? Let me show you some more things. Book and PDF mockups are used to create promotional images of a book, a PDF, or digital product. They include the cover page, as we see here, and could also include various interior content pages that you wish to highlight or feature for the viewer. When you add a shadow effect or a drop shadow. This can give an added dimension to the images used to communicate the books, the PDFs, or the digital product's weight. For instance, here you can see it suggests a multi-paged book, PDF, or digital product of significant value. In this example, you see that the mock-up has many pages available and present here within this digital product. With the shadow effects added, this suggests that even more pages are available within your product, assuring your customer that they are purchasing or opting in for a product with significant value. Adding shadow effects can also make your icons or images look clickable. When you see a raised image, like here, it organically communicates to your audience that it might be a button or a clickable image. The circled arrow icon has an additional shadow effect, which transforms the icon to look like a clickable button and encourages your audience to take action and click the button. I have a time tip for you. If you want to make sure that your raised images support clickable action with your audience, then make sure that all, or at least most of your shadow images, actually are clickable and lead to further information. Your audience will learn to expect to learn more when they click on your shadowed images. You just have to train them. Practice makes perfect. It's like herding cats. Shadow effects also add dimension and can make your image and products actually look real. The image below, you can see with the added shadow effects here, now looks like a real piece of art hanging on the wall of an art gallery with the focus completely on the image or product. If your image is actually the same color or even similar in color to your background, a shadow effect can easily distinguish your image in a minimalist way by adding a subtle distinction between your image and the background. In the example here, you can see this white circle is distinguished from the white background by adding a contrast here with this circle shadow effect. Simple, beautiful, and elegant. Adding distinction between similar, or even in this case, the exact same colors between the image and the background. With shadow effects, your images will literally stand out amongst the crowd as they appear to become three-dimensional and will pop off the page. It's amazing how effective the added shadow effect in the middle image here makes the second image float above the other images and pops it off the page. Although all three images are the same, the middle image with the shadow effect added definitely stands out in the crowd. So, it's time to get down to brass tacks now. How do we do it? Well, when I began working with Canva, which I absolutely love, it's what I started out in the very first year of my blog, and as I've grown as a blogger, so is Canva. I'm super happy with it. It's super easy to learn. I highly recommend it. So when I researched with Canva ways to add shadow effects, the suggestions I found included, to begin with, you make a copy of your image, and then you, on that copy, you adjust the saturation, the blur, the transparency settings on the copy. You move the copy behind the image, and then you adjust the position, and then you continue to go back and have to work on the transparency, all those settings, because sometimes the details of the copy comes through in the image, and you move the copy behind your original and you offset it to the shadow angle you wish. And yes, this does create a shadow effect. And this is exactly what I do when I'm adding shadow effects for text. But honestly, I was really not happy with how it looked with my images. And here's why. I liked the crisp edge for the shadow for my text, But in my opinion, it was just too crisp on the edges for images, and the intensity of the shadow was not what I was looking for. I wanted something a little bit richer for images. Not to mention, it was just so labor intensive to adjust the additional settings over and over again to get the image shadow the quality that I was wanting over and over again and create this effect with every single image.
This was driving me crazy.
So I decided to put an end to the madness, and I asked myself, how can I quickly and easily add shadow effects to my images in one click? There's got to be a way. And I thought to myself, okay, number one, I need a resource that includes templates for all of the sizes or perspectives of images that I use all the time. So that I can just add it in one click. Boom. Click. Snap. Done. Okay, number two, I wanted a rich intensity in color. So I had a deeper range of transparency options that maintain that richness, that intense color, even as I went down in my transparency so that the details of the original image would not bleed through in the shadow. Not too much to ask. And three, I wanted a realistic fade blur along the edges of the shadow. Not this crisp edge that I was finding, which is perfect for text. But for the images, I wanted something that actually had an authentic fade blur. And finally, I wanted to be able to add it in one click. Because I wanted to get back to the fun part of creating new valuable content for my audience instead of this continual repetitive task of all these technical things. Okay, so here we are. At the end of the road, what I did was I created the shadow effects collection with templates and the perspectives that I normally use. There are 7 templates in the collection: letter size, book cover, square, rectangle in a 2-3 perspective, rounded rectangle in a 2-3 perspective, a rounded square, and a circle. And now I can add a perfect shadow image in a simple one click. With the shadow effects collection, my design is finished in actually 3 steps. I add the template in the correct perspective that I'm using in my design in one click. Then I change the transparency, I position it and move it behind, and I'm done. That's it. Easy peasy. Sometimes I do use a combination of some of the templates depending upon what look I'm wanting with the design, and I'm going to, if you're interested in seeing exactly how I use them, then you can look at this suggested video right here and you can find a complete tutorial on how to do that. So are you ready to get started? You can find the shadow effects collection. The link is down here below. Make sure you like it. That's a big thumbs up. Do the like, ring the bell, so you get notified when I have more videos coming out. And please subscribe and be in my tribe. I'm just going to throw down all the emotional manipulation I can here in this moment. Be in my tribe. Help me grow. The Shadow Effects Collection is a resource that can help you connect the life you would love to the life you were living. How is that? Well, it compresses multiple repetitive tasks into just a simple add-in feature. It makes room for you to transform your life back into a more creative mode as opposed to spending so much time into technical repetitive tasks, and it provides a simple, beautiful, and meaningful outcome. Your time is a treasured commodity. Think about other ways that you could actually automate other repetitive tasks in your life or compress multiple tasks into a simpler process. Think about it and write down maybe 3 things that you could do to improve that process. And make sure you let me know. Share them downstairs in the comments. Because I need tips too, you know. And just remember, you don't have to sacrifice a simple, beautiful, and effective outcome for an efficient solution. Beauty and efficiency can live in the same house. And you'll be surprised. When you find the solution, you're going to be surprised at how simple it really is. Good fortune to you and your amazing blog. You're my everybody. That's it in a nutshell. Crack. Eat the nut.